All right, good morning, everybody. This is AV2 lesson one. This will be unit, what is this, unit six? Yeah, this is unit six. So after this chapter, then what do we have? Cumulative, okay? So if you don't like four or five test scores, or maybe you're already saying, I don't like six test score, even though we haven't done any of the lesson yet, you can retake on that cumulative. That cumulative will be the week after Thanksgiving. Okay, so let's get started here. We're gonna identify and draw some solids, learn some new vocabulary, and visualize three-dimensional shapes. So here is a prism. And a prism is a solid that has two bases of the same shape, which are parallel to each other, and then has these lateral faces. So here are, in this case, here are the two bases. What shape are those? Six-sided. Hexagon, so that would be a hexagonal prism. What would this thing be called other than maybe a cube? What if these were rectangles and not squares? It'd be a rectangular prism. And then this right here, these two are the bases, they're parallel to each other. Therefore, that would be a triangular prism. The vertical lines that connect them are called lateral edges. And each of those lateral edges run parallel to each other. Right. That right there is a prism. Okay. There are two types of prisms. One is a right prism, and one is called an oblique prism. The one on the left side here is called a right prism because the lateral edges make a right angle with the bases. Right. You see the right angle right here and right here. Well, that's not the case over here, right? This angle right there, or this angle right there, they are not right angles. Therefore, that is called an oblique prism. So you remember when we calculated the surface area of a rectangle? We said base times height. And then when we calculated the area of a parallelogram, I said, watch out for the child snipe, right? I said, watch out for getting sniped. By what? Well, this shape right here is no longer a rectangle, it is a parallelogram. Therefore, the altitude is the same thing as the height. So some child will call this the height of that side, and they will be wrong, right? They will be incorrect. Okay, we'll get to more of that in a little bit. That's called an oblique triangular prism. All right, so how many bases in this hexagonal prism? How many bases? Bases are parallel to each other? Yeah, there are two. There are two. Two bases. How many lateral edges? Vertically, how many edges do I have? Six, right? And there's no coincidence that the number of lateral edges is equal to the number of sides of the base, right? It's a hexagonal prism, therefore there's six lateral edges. How many lateral faces? Now, a lateral face is this space right here, or this space right here, or this space right here. And in three dimensions, it's hard to see it, right? Because you're like, oh, you're coloring over a bunch of stuff, but there's also six lateral faces. An example of an altitude, in this case, using letters, one of the altitudes could be CJ. What would be another altitude? CJ or BK. Yeah, some of you like have it your way, right? Or FG, right? Altitudes are heights, and height in this case could be represented by any one of these lateral edges. Right? That would be the height because it is a right hexagonal prism. Okay, cool. Let's continue. I'm going to skip this page for now. And I want to move on to this. Let's draw some three-dimensional figures. So I want to draw a right triangular prism. So how many triangles will there be in this prism? Two, right? Now I'm going to do my best to draw that same shape. And, oh, look at that. I have to draw three lateral edges. And as long as that's a right angle, And that's a right angle, and that's a right angle. Then we've got a right triangular prism. How about an oblique rectangular prism? Okay, so what shape should I sketch to start? A pentagon? No. A rectangle? Yeah. I'm gonna draw a rectangle. I'm gonna draw it in a different perception, different view here. Okay, now this is gonna be interesting. Let's do this. I don't want it to be directly below the other one, so I'm gonna shift it just a tiny bit. Now you have the ability on NoteAbility to just copy it. That'd be a nice little oblique rectangular prism. That's cool. I think the bases is the top and the bottom of like the cereal box, or I don't know, a triangular prism like a Toblerone bar. You know a Toblerone bar? Yep, I think of a triangular prism as a Toblerone bar. This could be like a shipping box that's been tipped, and it's been pushed to the side a little bit. It's no longer rigid and rectangle or right angles at all corners. Okay, so here's a pyramid. How many bases does a pyramid have, you think? Only one. And then what shape has to connect to the peak? Triangles. So all pyramids have triangles. There are certain pyramids that have only triangles, which would be a triangular based pyramid like this one. But otherwise, if you have a five-sided base, how many triangles do you have? Five. If you have a 10-sided base, a decagon on the bottom, you'll have 10 triangles, etc. Depends on the number of sides. So let's continue and take a look at some of or sketching this triangular pyramid as opposed to a rectangular pyramid. What's the difference? Triangular pyramid as opposed to a rectangular pyramid. What's the difference? Okay, so this word right here represents the shape of the base. So I'm going to draw a triangle. Now that triangle could be any kind of triangle. It could be a right triangle, it could be an equilateral, isosceles, scalene, doesn't matter. And then I just have to put a vertex somewhere up here. I'll put it right about there. Now, when you sketch these, I would, if I were you, just use a dashed line to give it some depth, right? If I were being a good geometry teacher, I would probably take and show that this is on the back side of that pyramid. Just to give it some depth, like I said. Okay. That kind of makes sense, right? You can see the front face is closest to you and the dashed lines are in the back of the shape. Okay, so that would be a triangular pyramid, a rectangular pyramid. Let's see if I can do it right this time without having to go back and erase. You can already see where I'm going with this. Let's put our vertex up here somewhere. So that would be good. That would be in the back end of the shape, and there. Oh, cool. Okay, your sketching skills are not going to be judged, right? If you're not good at kind of keeping spacing right and anticipating where a good vertex would be, then, you know, so be it. We'll be all right. Okay. All right, let's continue. What shape is this? Don't look at the top. Why would you look at the top and read that word? It's a cylinder, right? I don't know, this might be dog food can, sweet tarts, just straight up hockey pucks, just sniping all over the brim, just top shelf. Yeah, just rattle them home. Just pipe. Okay, what shape are the bases of these cylinders? Circles. Oh, now we don't have polygons on the bases, we have circles. Okay. Have you ever seen what's called a net? Do you know what a net is? No, I'm not talking about a hockey net. I'm talking about what if I unrolled a cylinder? You ever seen a net? So if I rolled that up, right, that would become a hockey puck. I'd fold the two circles in and roll up the rectangle. That'd be one heck of a thick hockey puck. Right? Be pretty thick. So this would probably be more realistic. probably more realistic for the thickness of a hockey puck. Okay, so there's a net of a cylinder. If we cut that cylinder horizontally, what shape would the cross section be? So let's say I make a cut, right? I make a cut right here. What would that red shape be? If I looked at it, if I just looked at the red shape, that surface, what would that shape be? A circle, right? What if I cut it vertically? What if I cut it vertically? This is going to be harder to show. What shape would that be? Well, look at a hockey puck from the side. What shape would it be? Rectangle, right? That'd be a rectangle. Okay. Now let's look at cone. Okay, cone. That's a cone. That's a cone. What the heck? That's a pine cone. That doesn't. That's, what the heck? No, mathematical joke. Not funny, Mr. Love. Okay. What if we cut a cone horizontally? Let's cut it horizontally. What shape would that be? Say again. Nope. If I cut a cone like that horizontally and then I look at it, and I pull it and I look at it, well, that'd be a circle. What would happen to that circle the closer I get to the top? Smaller. How about toward the bottom? Bigger. Closer you cut it toward the bottom, the bigger it is, the smaller at the bottom or at the top. Okay, now Samani, what if I cut this vertically? Oops, that should be dashed. There's a low hum on this mic today. I'm not liking it. That would be a triangle, right? And the closer I cut it to the middle, the larger that triangle would be. You with me? Okay. So that's called a cross section. Right. Let's keep going. An example, here's a sphere, right? We got a tennis ball, a jawbreaker, and I don't know what, if those are like special, just like special order pool ball. I don't know. I don't know why two of them are. Maybe they're marbles. I don't know. Hi, Dylan. Go ahead and take a seat. For right now, just grab an open seat. We're going to figure out seating chart later. Okay, here's a hemisphere. Anybody ever got one of these in the cereal box? Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's right. Okay. And then nets. Ooh, nets. Let's draw a couple of these. I'm going to draw a cube. How many square faces on a cube? Six, right? Right? When you roll a die, it's got six numbers. Okay, so I'm going to do a cube here. Tell me whether or not this would be a good net for a cube. Would that work? Fold that thing up. Yeah, that would work. What would this be the net of? We just did cylinder. Cool. How about a square-based pyramid? Ooh, that's kind of weird. Right, I got a square on the bottom. I got rectangles. These are not well drawn, as you can tell. And then I got a square on the top. Ooh, yeah, so if I fold up those four rectangles and then flop the square right on top, boom, I got myself a nice square base. Oh, pyramid, not prism. What are you doing, Mr. Love? Not prism, pyramid. Let's try that again. What did I do? What does a pyramid have that a prism doesn't? Triangles for the lateral faces, right? So let's try that again. Okay, so I got a square base and then I got a bunch of triangles. How many triangles? Four. Oh, because it's a square. Fold those up. Sweet. Okay, last one here. Pentagonal based prism. Gross. Pentagon. Pentagon. Oh my gosh, terrible. That was supposed to be a pentagon. Look at how bad that was. Yeah, I know. Let's try again. Pentagon. That was decent. And then I got myself a prism. What's true about all of these rectangles? They gotta be congruent, right? All five of those rectangles will fold up, and then the pentagon, this will be the top, and this would be the bottom. Those two would be the bases, and they just go whoosh, closed up. Right, so guess what shape this would be if I were to roll this up? Cone, yeah, sweet. You got it.